Hello, everyone. Today, we'll be talking about the total solution cost of an integrated inductor power module, including what to consider when making a comparison to an equivalent converter-based solution with a discrete inductor. Modules have historically carried the reputation of being expensive, but costs have come down significantly thanks to process and material advancements. For example, the cost of the TLVM13630 is about 75% lower than the LMZ14203, which was first introduced in 2010. The total solution size of the TLVM13630 is also significantly smaller. Let's take a look at how the same TLVM13630 buck module compares to a parametrically similar converter for a 24-volt input, 5-volt output, 10-watt design. This is a pretty typical requirement for many industrial applications. The LM60430D buck converter was selected for the comparison since it is the smallest package 36-volt 3-amp converter in the portfolio, and it switches at a similar frequency of about 1 MHz. In terms of performance, the LM60430 is about 2.5% more efficient, but the module is about 30% smaller and requires 2 fewer external components. In terms of IC price, the module is about $1 more expensive, but the complete BOM is only 10 cents or less than 5% higher. So the module-based solution is still slightly more expensive, but it's pretty close to the same 1KU webbench cost of the converter solution. But to compare costs of a module to a converter, we need to look beyond the aggregate component costs. Most designers just focus on the material costs, which is the cost of the IC and all supporting passives. To get a complete picture, however, designers must also consider PCB costs and design time. PCB costs add up quickly depending on the board area required, complexity of routing, number of vias, and the number of components placed on the board. With modules, these PCB costs are reduced due to the high level of integration and internal optimization. Calculating design time depends on a variety of factors, like the complexity of the IC, experience of the designer, and qualification process. A module is usually the easiest, fastest solution, and thus the cheapest, as they reduce design time by almost half. This is because the designer doesn't necessarily need to be involved with the control architecture scheme. There is no inductor selection, qualification, and sourcing needed. A lot of the DC-DC converter layout challenges are mitigated, and prototyping can be quick and efficient due to the simplicity of the solution. Designers must ask themselves if they can recoup that slightly higher material cost of the module-based solution with the potentially significant cost savings that come with a shorter design time. In summary, module costs have come down significantly since the first release in 2010. And even though the module may carry a higher IC price tag, the total solution cost can be very competitive with that of a discrete converter solution. In the case of the TLVM13630, the BOM cost is only about 5% higher at 1KU. Factoring in the PCB cost savings and design time savings, the TLVM13630 could be the more cost-effective option. Learn more about the impact the TLVM13630 can have on your design by visiting ti.com/power modules. Thanks for watching.